we're asked to simplify 9 squared, and that quantity, whatever 9 squared is, and we think we know what it is, it's 81, but we'll keep it at 9 squared. They need to simplify 9 squared to the third power. And they want us to express our answer in exponential form, which is just another way of saying that they want us to keep it as exponents. They don't want us to multiply it out and get some really, really large number. So let's think about how to do this. So we could 9 squared to the third power. Well, the simplest way to do this is just if you know the exponent rule or the exponent property, that if you raise something to an exponent, and then if you raise that entire thing to another exponent, then you can just multiply these two exponents. So this is going to be the same thing as 9 to the 2 times 3 power, which is the same thing as 9 to the 6th power. And we'd be done. We've expressed our answer in exponential form, 9 to the 6th power. We've simplified. Now, you say, what's not exponential form? What's not exponential form is if we were to actually multiply 9 times 9 times 9 times 9 times 9 times 9, which is going to be a very, very large number. And we would probably want a calculator, or it would take us some time. So 9 to the 6th is the answer. Now, another way to view it, if you don't like to just like that formula, is we could even apply other formulas. What's another way to think about 9 squared to the third power is, I'll do this in a different color just for fun, 9 squared times 9 squared times 9 squared, right? This is 9 squared to the third power. And we also know the other exponent property, or the other exponent rule, that if you have the same base being raised to different powers, or in this case, they're all being raised to the same power, this is the same thing as, and you're taking the product of them, then this is the same thing as taking that same base, that 9, and raising it to the sum of the powers. So 9 to the 2 plus 2 plus 2, which is, once again, 9 to the 6. In fact, I don't even have to write it again. That's once again 9 to the 6. So either way, you're going to get the same thing. And just be very clear. Here, we added the exponents because we had the same base, and we're multiplying them. So we added the exponents. Here, we multiplied the exponents because we had something to an exponent, and then that whole thing being raised to another exponent. But regardless of which direction you go in, as long as you use your properties in the correct way, you should get 9 to the 6th power.